how to rebuild trust in a relationship. Hey guys, my name is Danny and I'm your life and a relationship coach. And obviously based on the title of the video, we are talking about trust and how to rebuild it in a relationship. First and foremost, if you are in a position, if you are in a situation in which you feel like you have lost trust in your partner, I empathize with you. It is not an easy place to be. It has a tendency of feeding into insecurities. You have a tendency of potentially blaming yourself, feeling bad, building. It can be a really bad, dark place to be in. And I get it. It's difficult to try to manage and navigate those feelings and those emotions when you want to still be in the relationship with that person. So the question becomes, how do you rebuild the trust, right? How do you get into a position where you feel comfortable enough and vulnerable enough to be able to let that person back in? And there are a few things, obviously, that I wanted to cover in order to really kind of start the process. And this specifically kind of is geared towards the individual who broke the trust. If you are the individual that broke the trust, one of the primary things that you have to focus on and you have to realize is that consistency is key. Consistency is going to be everything in regards to rebuilding the trust. And here's the reason why. If you have lost trust, if your partner has lost trust in you because of your actions and anything you did, and it depends on the severity of the action, right? Was it infidelity? Was it that you lied about something? Was it that you were hiding something from them for an extended period of time that they didn't know? Whatever the case may be, you are going to have to show them that you are reliable. And in order to show them that you are reliable, you have to be consistent. So it is as simple as if you tell your partner you're going to be home at 5 o'clock, you are home at 5 o'clock. If you tell your partner that you are going to go and do something, you go and do that exact same thing and you come home with whatever it is you said you were going to go buy. If you tell your partner that you are going to go pick up the kids at school for the next 3 days, you go and pick up the kids from school for the next 3 days. Whatever it is that you have to do, you have to make sure that you are sticking to what you say and the plan and you are being consistent with it for an extended period of time. And guys, girls, whatever the case may be, whoever this situation is geared towards, it's really just about showing your partner that you can show up for the relationship, right? And it can be really exhausting. I completely understand because you feel like now you are having to make up for a mistake that you made. But at the end of the day, if you so choose to remain in the relationship, if you choose to make the relationship work, it is a sacrifice that you are going to have to be willing to make in order to make the relationship work and in order to regain the trust of your partner. The second thing is transparency, right? Being completely open and vulnerable, not withholding information, answering any questions that your partner may have. And again, just really kind of being transparent with how you're feeling. Oftentimes when the trust has been broken, of course you are also a human being. And if you are the person who caused the trust to be broken, you're gonna have days where you're tired. You're gonna have days where you're emotionally exhausted and you're going to want to just isolate and shut off. But you have to be able to communicate with your partner when you are having those days, right? Transparency. Because if you're not, your partner is going to think that something weird and shady is going on again, right? Because you're not communicating, you're shutting down, you're isolating yourself. And that is the last thing that you want to do. And again, like I mentioned, it kind of falls and piggybacks off of consistency. So communication should be consistent. Your ability to be transparent should be consistent. And again, you know, if there is something going on with you emotionally, it's okay to allow yourself to be vulnerable and to open up and to let your partner know what is going on. Because if you don't do that, it is going to cause your partner to become more suspicious. It will further feed their insecurities. They will become either more upset, more needy, more clingy. You will feel more suffocated. And it's just this entire cycle that continues over and over and over again. The last piece of the puzzle is actions over words, right? I hear this all the time from people, you know, well, I told her that I was going to do this. I promised that I was going to do this. I promised that I was going to do this for him. I swore that I would never, whatever the case may be, your words mean nothing right now. It's only your actions because your words, in a sense, are really kind of what led you to this situation. Right? Maybe you weren't speaking enough. Maybe you weren't being honest in the way that you were saying things. Maybe you were withholding information. Maybe you were, you know, communicating, but you weren't communicating effectively, or maybe you were lying. Whatever the case may be, your words are most likely also what got you in this situation, let alone your actions. Whatever it is you did, infidelity, lying, it's, withholding information, whatever the case may be, whatever caused the trust to be broken in the relationship, it is going to take you stepping up to the plate, showing up for the relationship, and showing your partner that you are willing to actively make the changes. And how you show them through your actions, again, is through being consistent and is through being transparent. So if you are telling your partner that you are going to do something, follow through with it. You know, if you were telling your partner that you are actively going to go to therapy to try to work through some of your traumas, go to therapy. Make sure that you are scheduling that out. Doing whatever you have to do to actually show your partner that you are sorry and that you're committed to the process and that you are taking accountability for your actions. If you guys like this video, please make sure you hit the like and subscribe button down below. I love having conversations with people. So if you have an opinion, if you have any questions, maybe if you have some tips that worked for you, please make sure you leave them in the comment box down below. I try to read as many of them as possible. I also try to comment on as many as possible as well. Maybe you just want to dive a little bit deeper. You want to know a little bit more. You can visit us at www.happilycommitted.com, where we have a multitude of different articles and blogs and videos related to this subject and many other subjects as well. Maybe you just feel like you need a little bit more support, right? Your situation or your circumstance is very particular and you need a coach to help you and guide you. I would be more than happy to support you through that process. You can book with either myself or any of the other amazing coaches that we have on the team via the website. Again, my name is Danny. I'm your life and a relationship coach. Hope you're staying happy and healthy, and I'll see you soon.